Hey, Bruce Gabriel here with 101 PowerPoint Tips for Business Managers. And today we're going to be talking about how to turn clip art into your own set of professional-looking custom icons. Now, I'd like you to imagine that you're heading into the boardroom with a slide like this. Now, this is a very simple slide. It only has three bullet points. And some people argue that you shouldn't use bullet points at all, but that's not really true because when you take the bullet points away, you're left with a slide that looks something like this. Just three pieces of text floating in space. Bullet points actually serve a useful purpose. They're called signposts, and they give the eye a place to start reading on the slide. Now, you don't have to use bullet points. You could use something else. For example, you could use pictures. Here's an example of three pieces of clip art. But the problem is that clip art doesn't look very professional. I mean, these pictures don't really match. The colors don't really harmonize. It doesn't look the way you want to present in the boardroom. But I'm going to show you a really neat trick for taking clip art and turning it into your own custom set of professional-looking custom icons. So the way we do that is we draw the outside of the icon. In this case, I'm going to choose a circle and hold down the Shift key and make a big circle. Now I want to give it a fill color. I'll go to the Format tab and I'll go to the Fill tab and choose maybe purple. And to make it more pleasing looking, I'll give it a gradient fill as well. And again, just for a nice artistic touch, I'm going to give it a drop shadow. And then for the outside border, I'm going to make it white, and I'm going to make it relatively wide, maybe about 4.5 point. So now we have the outside of the icon. It looks very nice. The next thing we need to do is we need to put the clip art in. So we go up to the Insert tab. And we choose Insert Clip Art. And I'm going to search for cell phone. Now we're looking for a certain type of image called a vector image. And a vector image is an image that you can ungroup it into different shapes, squares and circles and lines and things like that. So, for example, this is not a vector image, and I can tell by right-clicking on it, and you can see the group tab is grayed out. This kind of non-vector artwork, it looks hand-drawn or looks like a painting. It has lots of shading and things like that, and I don't want that, so I'll go ahead and delete it. What I want is something like this. This is a vector artwork, and I can confirm that by right-clicking on it. And you can see the group tab is available to me, and I can go ahead and I can ungroup this image. And I have to go ahead and select yes and then ungroup it one more time. And when I do that, you can see it's made up of different shapes, circles and squares and things like that. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to delete the pieces that I don't need. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this square right here. And now I can't quite tell what I have anymore, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to select everything that's left so I can see what I've got left. And you can see I've got some circles and some squares. And I'm just going to drag it onto this icon so I can start working with it. I'll go ahead and I'll delete that square. I saw another square back there I want to get rid of. And now I'm going to zoom in on this image. I'll go down to my lower right corner, grab the zoom bar, and just zoom in so I can get close to this because I'm going to do some close-up finishing touches here. The first thing I want to do is choose all of these oval and round shapes, and I'm going to fill them in with a color that matches the background color of the icon, so it all looks like it's part of the same thing. So I'll just hold down the Shift key and I'll select each of these images. Then I'll go back up to the Format tab and go to Shape Fill and choose Purple. And you can see now it matches the background. There's one more line here. Actually, this is a skinny rectangle. I'll go ahead and select that and fill it in with purple. And now we're done. We've got an icon that is all cleaned up and ready to be used on this circle. So I'll go ahead and I'll just regroup these shapes. Hold down my grab these shapes, right-click it, and go back to group them up again. And now I can resize it and make it fit nicely on this button. And there you go, you have this very nice looking icon. So I can go ahead and select both of those items, right click, group them. So I got it down to one object that I can work with. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to resize this down to the size I want to use. So I get it down, I hold down the shift key, and I resize it. I get it down to this nice button size. Now, one thing you'll notice is that the border around it has maintained its original size of 4.5 point. Now, maybe I don't want that. Maybe it looks too wide. Maybe I want to go in there and change that. So I'll go ahead and I'll choose that icon again. I'll right-click it, and I'll ungroup it. And then I'll select the circle, go back to my Format tab, and choose Shape Outline, and maybe I'll bring it down to maybe 2.25 point. And there you have it, this nice little icon. I'll just grab everything, regroup it. And now it's ready to use. And so I can just take this back to my original boardroom slide, and it'll look something like this. And I still have the two other pieces of clip art. And by doing the same thing, by just ungrouping them, deleting the things I don't need, and then regrouping them on an icon, I can create my own professional-looking set of custom icons. I love this trick. I use it all the time. It only takes a few minutes to create really professional-looking custom icons. In fact, now that you have these beautiful icons, you might want to show them off with a different layout, something like this. I do want to thank my colleague, Magda Maslowska, who taught this trick to me, and I'm now sharing it with you. Magda's a great presentation designer and graphic designer, and I encourage you to go check out her website. I'm Bruce Gabriel. For more information about my book and more tips on creating clearer and more persuasive-looking boardroom slides, you can go to speakingppt.com.